been a very long time since Capcom has released a Resident Evil project that I'm truly invested in. The fact that this game managed to bring in old-school fans and first-timers into this masterclass experience is awesome. If you have a little bit of faith in Capcom, then help us support them by buying it or at least renting it. Show Capcom that we give a f-. No, no, that's a little too profane. No, I can't use the word f-. That's too much profane. Too much profanity in this video already. How about something more family friendly? Damn, yeah, damn is good. Yeah, dude, I use damn. Show Capcom that we give a damn. And if the rumors are true that Resident Evil 3 is in the works right now, and I let's hope it's the Shiznits. Shiznit. What the fuck am I thinking? Something more. No. A bit too cheesy. Faith. Yeah, full faith in Capcom. I'm excited for it, and I'm looking forward to it. Until then, I'll be playing more Resident Evil 2! Well, thank you so much for watching. I hope you like this video. Well, it's a review now, so I can say review! This review, and if you do, go ahead and click the like button, click the bell, and subscribe if you haven't already. Now I'll see you every time I see you. And boom! Done. Finally finished. And that only took me 5 f***ing months to write this review. No big deal. Whew! Now that the script is finished, all I got to do is play it out. Let's do this. Homies, this is Ludi. I'm sorry it took so long to upload this review. Most of you probably don't even give a shit about this review right now. I don't even care anymore. This is for entertainment. Time to finish what I started a long, long time ago. Resident Evil 2 review. Let's get into it! Wow. Resident Evil 2. Holy cow. For 3 years, I set such high anticipation for this game, hoping that it would not be another dumpster fire. Thank God it's not. This is possibly one of the best Resident Evil slash zombie games that I've ever played in my life. If you are a fan of zombies, survival horror, I highly suggest you give this a buy or at least give it a try, because this, I believe, is a great beneficial purchase. I found this game fun, addicting, a little bit exhausting. At times, I had to put the controllers down, go downstairs, get myself ready for the next hours of playthrough. Remake, if they're already doing it, I'm so excited! Resident Evil today still stands to be one of my favorite concepts of all time. I just love the in-game mechanics, the style, and the storytelling. I didn't mind more of the action-centric Resident Evil title, say to Resident Evil 5 for an example. I accept Resident Evil 5 for what it is. I do believe this is a very underrated game, I found a lot of fun to it, and I still think the story's pretty damn good. Still, Resident Evil 5 and other titles after that started losing the rhythm of what gave them the title, and Resident Evil 6 completely lost all of it. That is why I'm so happy that Resident Evil 2 is brought back into this modern generation. It reminds me of what made Resident Evil great in the first place, and it teaches me the real meaning of survival horror. It goes back to playing two characters with their own scenario, and I love the idea of Leon and Claire taking hold of their own side of the story. That is one of the things I love about the older Resident Evil games. The concept of playing two sides of one storyline is rare for me to see in a video game. And that is something I'd definitely like to see more often in future Resident Evil titles. No! That doesn't count! This is a remake of the original game made in 1998. This is a reimagining ground-up rebuild of the original, not going back, but starting from, if you know what I mean. This new edition is utilizing the Resident Evil 7 engine, and the game looks incredible! There's so much attention to detail that Resident Evil 2 is able to master in pixelation. The redesign of the RPD and everything else around it absolutely floored me, and I could tell there was so much passion placed into it. The enemies are a lot more improved, vicious, and scarier than I remember in any Resident Evil title. The animation on character models are absolutely insane. It is so cool to see Leon and Claire's facial structure captured by real people. And it definitely shows what our modern gaming technology can really do. This game is visually impressive. This is possibly the best looking Resident Evil game that I've ever played, if not one of the best looking horror games that I've ever played. Resident Evil 2 mirrors the concept of the original game and it reflects huge gameplay differences. Just like the original, he plays two characters. One, Leon Kennedy, a rookie cop starting his first day on duty. And Claire Redfield, a college student searching for a brother who's another badass you play in the other games. Both Leon and Claire randomly find each other at a gas station and get ambushed by zombies. They have to make their way to the Raccoon City police station. Once they get to the RPD, they realize the entire place is dead! Now they have to go around, shoot zombies, solve puzzles, read documents, and it's so addicting, it is addicting as hell! So in the original Resident Evil 2, as well as the other older games, use a fixed camera angle. What it is a wide, high, and low shot of your character in different angles. Like when you enter a room, you'll see your character from one angle. When you go further into the room, it'll change its position to another angle so you can see where you're going. And when the scares come in, you hear a creepy, crumpling sound and you don't know exactly what it is. You go further and further into the room, and then once you turn the corner of a hallway, the camera changes, and all of a sudden, boom, a zombie! The game mechanics are very similar to the other Resident Evil games. This is played in third-person perspective. Now, I don't mind over the shoulder, just as long as I can keep the same level and scare tactic. I myself found this game just as scary as the original. I mean, not only is this game dramatically dark, I couldn't see through most places without a flashlight. There were moments of apprehension every time I enter a room or a really dark hallway because I didn't know what the hell was gonna happen. I didn't know if I was gonna get attacked, chased, or killed for that matter.
Oh shit! You son of a bitch.
Panic is something I've not felt since the very first Resident Evil game, and I'm glad that this new edition has given that to me. The zombies are unlike any other zombies I've seen in a Resident Evil game, and I've never had this much fun killing down zombies in a Resident Evil game ever! Every damage the zombie takes, the reaction is so beautifully realistic, the damage is well done, the blood and gore is fucking beautiful to look at, I just love how gory this game is, I fucking love it! In the laws of zombie physics, you'd think one simple headshot would take him out, right? Well, in this game, it doesn't really work that way. In fact, it actually takes 3 to 4 headshots to take a zombie down temporarily. I mean that they would most likely get up seconds, minutes, hours later when I could at least expect it.
Wow. You just never quit. Get up, bitch. What? Damn, your face is fucked up.
There is one shot you could take. It's very similar to the previous games, say 4, 5, and 6, where you shoot one spot, one specific spot in the head that causes it to explode. In the other games, the spot I always aimed for was the neck area, and it would most likely work. Unfortunately, in this one, there's really no true target in the head area to aim for. It's just kind of random.
See, I'm trying to think. It's really good to think that, like, if you played this before, it's good to think if you're going to go back in this room eventually. Probably for the best, though. Might as well, right? Before Mr. X tries to kill me! Oh, shit! Okay. That was a lucky shot. Caught you off guard, motherfucker! Taking care of business, why won't I? Oh, damn, I thought I was lucky in that. You bastard.
What the hell?
I don't know what triggers her head to explode, but it's really awesome watching it happen. If only I knew the right pixel to aim for, then I can watch her head explode through my entire playthrough.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to fuck up your face. Are you dead, man? You gonna get up anymore?
The knives came off a lot more useful than I expected. I used it to chop their legs and arms off to make it very easy to pass them without wasting ammunition. When an enemy makes a jump on me, I could use the knife to push them away. The knives do stay on the enemies that I use it on. I was able to retrieve the knife after I took the enemy out. The knives do wear off, so it won't always be there depending on how many times I've used it. The zombies will sometimes break their way in. If I wanted to avoid any more zombies from coming in, I can board up the windows by using wooden boards scattered around the police station. It did hold more threats outside of the department, and when I boarded up the right windows, it showed results of fewer zombies appearing in a room that I had to backtrack to later in my playthrough. For every zombie that tries to break through glass, it gives me about 10 seconds to board up the windows before the glass shatters. If the glass breaks before I had a chance to board up the window, then it's too late, they're in. I just love how interactive this game can be. The fact that you can board up windows to keep enemies out, that is golden to me. I just love how challenging the first stage turned out to be for me in my first run.
It took me a little more than a bite on slice, if you know what I mean.
As if the zombies were not hard enough already, what could be worse than the zombies that could take up an entire pistol clip to kill? That answer just might be the lickers. These lickers, in my opinion, are a lot scarier than any other licker I've ever seen in a Resident Evil game. The rules on the licker hasn't changed, they are still blind and are only attracted by sound. It's definitely something I should have known better during my first playthrough, because I remember in Resident Evil 5, the last place I saw the lickers in, Sheva herself said, "Oh, they're only attracted by sound, we better keep quiet," and I totally forgot about that rule. Every time I try to fight these creatures, I end up getting the worst of it. One missed shotgun blast technically means I'm screwed. Either I'll get a critical hit by a licker, and if they take a jump on me with no defense, then that's game over. The introduction's a lot different compared to the original. In the original, either Claire or Leon walks through a hallway. As you go further, it jumps to a cutscene. Blood is dropping through the ceiling, your character looks up, and there's a licker. The very first encounter of a licker was very creepy, but also epic. The licker's greeting in the new one was not at all what I expected.
Oh! What the fuck? What the fuck? Huh? Fuck you! Oh shit! Oh, you shit, little bitch. Damn you. Oh my god.
I'm walking through this really dark hallway, then all of a sudden, the licker grabs onto this corpse with his nasty ass tongue. I didn't know what the licker was doing to that corpse, and I wanted no part of it. The first time I thought to myself, what could be worse than bullet sponge zombies that take up an entire pistol clip to kill? And if it's the lickers, what could be worse than the lickers? What could possibly be worse than a BOW who has a reflex of a trap jaw ant? That answer just might be the tyrant. What the fuck? This guy, who's also known as Mr. X, is the boogeyman of Resident Evil 2. He's a gigantic dude who wears a trench coat, a fedora, and he's insane! He chased me through the majority of the game, and his job is to murder my character in the most brutal way as possible, nothing more.
What the fuck?
Jesus Christ!
Woo! Woo! Oh shit! Oh fuck! He's fast! He's fast! He's fast! Oh fuck that noise!
Mr. X's absence from my own eyesight to only hear his footsteps did not make me feel any safer.
I can't hear him. Is he still around? I could hear. Oh fuck. Oh my god, this guy's terrifying. Whew! I hear him. Okay, as soon as he comes through here, I'm gonna just run right for it. Oh my god. That sound. I don't give a shit about that. But it's probably best if I do. Combine. I'm running for it. You f- oh, oh my god, it scared the shit out of me. This guy's scary as
And I believe his other purpose was to make one puzzle I had to solve difficult. Mr. X showed up at the end of the first stage while I was trying to retrieve two items. He caused me to do so much backtracking, I couldn't think where I had to go. The time it took me to find the piece and puzzle is the best progress I can make was to connect two items together. I tried to leave Mr. X away from the puzzle rooms while there are zombies in other rooms trying to eat me, liquors lingering around the fucking hallways trying to lick me. I can't run because the liquors are gonna hear me. I can't walk because Mr. X is on my ass. I can't go into other rooms because zombies are trying to ambush me, and I never know what to do. I die from a panic attack and it just becomes overwhelming. I want to find these fucking puzzles and the goddamn level!
Oh shit! Unfair! I fucking hate this shit.
I actually thought I got the hang of how the whole mechanical system works until Mr. X comes and fucks that up! I thought I was actually safe in the lobby because the lobby's part of the safe room, right? Well, apparently he can go through the lobby and he doesn't give a fuck!
Fuck you, door. Damn it!
The inventory kind of works the same as the other games. I mean, I could combine herbs into health, I carried only very limited supplies, I can discard items when I no longer need to use them, though items don't drop from enemies like in the other games. I actually had to scatter for ammunition, herbs through lockers, drawers, or shelves. This game actually did give me full caution of not to waste anything. There is very little I can carry in a pouch, though you can actually find more pouches scattered around, which gave me another reason to explore. There are items in the safe rooms where you could stash all your things that you wouldn't need at the moment. The item box actually really did help when it came to combining items. There are items I can find around the mask, but I wouldn't know exactly what it connects to. Either the other piece I had to connect it to is in the save box or is yet to be discovered. Once I did connect those pieces together, it revealed itself as another item that can unlock new weapons or parts to connect with my weapon. The inventory did become frustrating at times. The fact that I had to do so much backtracking, none of it would have been necessary if it weren't for the space usage that didn't make any sense. Why? Does it take one knife to fill up a single icon when the icon itself can fill up four wooden boards?
I don't know why I'm looking through here. I don't even have any room. I'm gonna have to go back.
See, look at this shit. Look. Knife. Look what I can do. 1, 2, 3, 4. No! I got four knives in my pocket? That would be considered as one icon, right? Oh man, wouldn't that make sense in my inventory? Look, check this out, I got a board! I bet I can fit it in my pocket, it's possible in the game, right? Let me try two. See if that will make any difference. Fuck. Three's a charm. Four is a magic number. Let's do it! Why isn't it fitting? This is a shoebox! No! Oh, I guess it did fit in my pocket. I can't seem to fit more than two knives in my f***ing inventory. Yeah, that was my little nitpick on the inventory. It's kind of bullshit. In the previous games, I was given a much larger selection of weapons considering I get introduced to weapons on most levels I go through. With game treasures, I was able to buy new weapons and also upgrade them. Both Leon and Claire get their own unique weapons. Starting with Leon, in the beginning, he gets a shotgun. The shotgun was very easy for me considering I can blow a zombie's head off immediately. Or if I was ambushed by zombies and I didn't have enough bullets for the pistol to blow their heads off, I could just shoot them in the leg and it'll take them down and I could just run right past them. The accuracy in a shotgun can be a little bit difficult, difficult, considering that I need to be in close counter with my enemies if I want to cause critical damage. On Claire's side, you get the grenade launcher. I love this weapon. It can cause a decent amount of damage no matter how far I am away from my enemies. This weapon can fire flame balls and acid. What I really like this weapon, it causes at least 5 seconds of critical damage as I'm reloading my gun, and made it so much easier for me during the boss fights. Grenade launcher can be a bit overpowering, considering that there's no weapons in between that makes me feel like I'm putting my ammo in fair use. The boss battles has been altered and expanded. Unfortunately, some of those didn't do any justice. Boss battles are supposed to be challenging, but I just didn't find some of them fair. There are times when I'm trying to stay away from the enemy as far away as possible, and the places I was fighting in were so small, it was very difficult for me to move around and get away from enemies when they're about to charge at me. It was a guarantee that I was going to take a critical hit, and there's no dodge combination that my character can replicate during these boss fights. There was no creativity for these boss fights. They had patterns, but no level. I just found most of them repetitive and lazy. The map is quite massive in this game. It is such an amazing relief not having to watch a pixelated door slowly opening, quilt/tutorial screen trying to get to the next level. All you have to do is push the door open, you're in a whole nother room, no loading screen, it's a fucking miracle. There are a few changes to structure and designing, some altered and improved, some sadly removed. Comparing to the original game, there's just a lot of areas and sequences that were cut out. The most I was disappointed with was the lack of city exploration. Exploring Raccoon City was something I was really looking forward to. The fact that this is a ground-up rebuild of a 20-year-old video game, I was really hoping that Capcom would take the advantage of showing off what our modern technology can do by rebuilding such an iconic fictional city like Raccoon City. Yes, the city does look really nice from the distance, it looks really nice in the opening credits too. It will be even nicer if I can actually explore the damn place.
There it is. The station.
Such bullshit, man! They could at least let me go around the city a bit longer.
The puzzles weren't as cool as the older Resident Evil games. They did cause me to do a little bit of backtracking. I didn't have too much of a problem with that. I mean, they all, in my opinion, are way better than Resident Evil 7 puzzles, which Resident Evil 2 actually did help my playthrough at a fair pace. On my first run, it took me 7 hours to beat it, 5 hours in my second run, and 3 hours, I believe, was the quickest time it took me to beat this game. In that way of saying, this game's f***ing short. I've heard numerous times that there are plenty of gamers out there who are able to beat this game in less than an hour. Now, I'll say to the player, hey, awesome, good job. But for Capcom, if someone has the capability of beating your modern day 2019 video game in less than an hour,
that's an epic fail!
This is a very short game, and I wish that Capcom would at least taken the time or effort to make this game at least impossible to beat in 5 hours. Like, seriously? Less than an hour? Not acceptable! There's no reason for a game to be this short, and there's no reason for any human being to have the capability of beating a game in less than an hour. That's just ridiculous. The option to make this game longer was not done, it was a missed opportunity, and frankly, a stupid move. There are first and second run scenarios. Now, whichever character that I play on the first run, as soon as I beat it, I have the option to click on the second run. My biggest criticism for these scenarios is how confusing they are, and the second run, in my opinion, makes no sense at all. The only few differences on the second run are the character and enemy encounters. The puzzles has been a little bit scrambled, the difficulty has been altered. The second run was a lot shorter than the first run, but it gave me the complete ending of the game. Other than those few changes, the second run is technically the same as the first run. It's a different story told in the same location. Doing most of the same things just defeats the purpose of why there's even a B scenario. It made me question of why would I be redoing the same stuff in the first and third act if the first run has already done those tasks for me. It was so disappointing, and I wish Capcom could have done better.
You blew it!
Besides that, there are still a lot of things to love about this game. There are many elements to the gameplay that was truly immersive by the way it presented itself. The gaming mechanics is awesome, the graphics are amazing, and for a Resident Evil title, the non-loading maps is impressively massive. I found Leon and Claire, and most of the side characters, very likable. On story perspective, though... Two scenarios were telling as a whole was okay for my taste. Despite compelling gameplay, stunning graphics, and amazing acting behind the characters, Resident Evil 2 just couldn't grab onto me with this mediocre plot. There were aspects to the story that did hit my emotional level, and I really do appreciate that, but it has yet to deliver a message that I myself can comprehend. In all that matter, the story just ended up not becoming as interesting as it should have been. The scenario crossover I felt were uneven, the chemistry between characters I felt were non-existent, I'm telling you, it was nowhere to be found. For an example, Leon and Claire are two characters I play in the game, they only encounter with each other twice in my entire playthrough, and yet, they still act like they've been longtime friends.
Claire, it's so nice to see you.
Bullshit!
When I played Leon on my first run, Claire became easily forgettable. When I played Claire on my second run, it was the same situation with Leon. Whichever character I didn't play was never acknowledged until the very end of the game. It is almost as if the writer gives a huge setup for these characters and never know what to do with them forward in. There's a lot of that in Resident Evil 2 and it got incredibly annoying. I do believe what hurt the story the most were the side characters. I can't say too much about them based on how little screen time they've had, though some of them I felt were completely unutilized. In the original game, they played a bigger role and carried a much more compelling story. Sadly, the concept was there, but it lacked the formula and needed to gain any sort of empathy for these characters. These anti-dimensional characters I felt were shamefully disposed in such a deep hole and dragged along a huge chunk of the story that I never got. These flaws that I have with the plot doesn't mean that I feel that Resident Evil 2 story is weaker than most, but I do believe that 20 years should have shown better results for its execution. You know, I will say the voice acting is pretty on point. Nick Apostolides, the voice over Leon Kennedy, did a pretty damn good job as a young version of Leon Kennedy. He did stand off as a pretty believable rookie cop who's never been in an outbreak before and is just trying to do nothing but good for his fellow citizens of Raccoon City. This is definitely the Leon Kennedy who has yet to learn a whole nother society that he soon will have to face. There may have been some line of dialogue that completely disconnected me from Leon. They just came off so cartoony and unnecessary. He's not the Leon Kennedy who's like, hey, I'm super hot and badass with my six-pack who likes to chase after the most annoying short skirt girl I can't fucking stand.
Don't come!
I remember when I lost my mind. Oh shit! Ashley, you bitch!
No! Watch out for me!
How am I supposed to do that?
No!
Are you fucking kidding me? You can't climb down a ladder by yourself.
Oh my god, I can't stand that bitch! Other than that shenanigans, I think that Nick Apostolides did a great job as Leon Kennedy, and I'm looking forward to more of his performance in the near future. Hopefully if they bring it back in the next Resident Evil games. Stephanie Panicello did just as well as Nikki Boo. She stood out as a fantastic younger Claire, and she presented a character as if it was an impurity of herself. I never got to play Claire Redfield too often, but it was really nice to bring a new actress to the table. She was believable to show that she is a brother of another badass. I believe that Claire's just been in the same amount of games as Chris, but my problem with these two characters is that they're barely in the same game. If not ever. And at least that Capcom could at least release a later title with those two together. That actually would be nice. It would be amazing if one Resident Evil title fleshed out the brother and sister relationship between Chris and Claire. What is the point of creating relatives that barely appear in the same title together? No afterlife does not count. I know you were thinking it.
We were all thinking it.
Just for once, turn Chris and Claire into the Team Rocket of Resident Evil.
Prepare for trouble.
Make it double.
To protect the world from devastation.
To unite all peoples within our nation.
To denounce the evils of truth and love.
To extend our reach to the stars above.
Jesse!
James!
Team Rocket, blast off at the speed of light!
Surrender now or prepare to fight!
Me out, that's right!
I'm getting way off topic. Just put these two characters in the same game, that's all I'm saying. Ada Wong is, of course, in this game, but this one's voiced over by Jolene Anderson. And to be honest with you, I don't really like this new version of Ada. They changed her so much in a way that it makes me kind of wish that they stuck with the original Ada. This new version of Ada Wong I just found incredibly annoying and way too goddamn suspicious.
Road's out. Going through that gun shop looks like the only way.
Wow, you had to walk all the way to the edge to realize the road's gone?
Her clothing doesn't make any sense at all, considering the fact that she's in a city full of zombies. I myself would think that someone like her would wear something that would make a little bit more survival sense. There's no reason for her to wear glasses in the dark. There's no reason for her to wear a dress. There's no reason for her to wear high heels. None of it makes any sense, and I'm sorry, but that's how I feel about Ada Wong in general. But I will say this Ada Wong, as well as most Ada Wongs, are 100 times better than the Ada Wong in Resident Evil Retribution. I was never a fan of Sherry Birkin between Original and 6. She always bugged the fuck out of me. She's constantly whining and running away from Claire and saying, "Oh, I gotta find my daddy and run into the most dangerous place I can find!"
Wait. Let me go!
Easy, easy there! I'm not a zombie!
What was that?
That's what I was telling you about! It's here!
Sherry, wait!
It's not that, Claire. It's because of my daddy. He's over there. I heard him call my name.
Wait, Sherry. Don't go alone. Sherry! Sherry!
This new Sherry Birkin, voiced by Lisa Pryor, is awesome. I didn't find her annoying at all. She was a major improvement, and I find her way better than all the Sherry Birkins. Better than the Sherry Birkin of Resident Evil 6. All commonly, acting in this game was really, really good. Oh my gosh, I forgot to mention, there's profanity in this game. It is so nice to hear Leon and Claire curse. I know it's a little weird to acknowledge something like that, but you have no idea how annoying it is for Resident Evil to have censored itself, and that's a problem I have with these games. They always say, "Damn! Darn it! Shit! Son of a bitch!" They don't even say the word f-. Resident Evil 7 and Resident Evil 2 Remake are the only two games where I know there's cursing in it. Like me, if I was about to be eaten by zombies, licked by lickers, or chased by tyrants, I would be cursing non-stop. Now, I'm not saying that you should just go around and saying curse, curse, curse.
Oh, Jesus! Crap! Oh, shit! Shit! Ah! Ah! Shit! You fucking asshole! You scared shit out of me!
I'm not saying that at all. I'm just saying that if you're in a really shitty situation and you feel like you need to say the word fuck, just say it.
Fuck! 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 Fuck this game, man! Fuck! Fuck!
Kirsten! Stop! Stop! Get it! Quit! Quit!
I love the profanity in this game! Woo! That was therapeutic. This may be an unpopular statement for present gamers, but the most important thing to make a video game worth $60 is that it's 100% finished. A single player campaign and extra content are very important to me. Those are the subjects that should already be provided in a video game at release, and Capcom, I believe, is very good at doing that. Some of those games may come out short, but in the end, their games come out completed as intended. The fact that these games come out on the exact release date as it was announced shows how dedicated they are to their games. After playing hours and hours of Resident Evil 2 still shows that Capcom are developers of integrity. The content in this game is really good, and it's such a relief not having to milk out my wallet just for something as simple as a costume. This game has allowed me to challenge myself by playing it in different ways. Depending on how I play the game, whether it's speedruns, difficulty, kills, puzzles, or saves, there's still a lot of cool things to unlock. After my first time completing A and B scenario, I unlocked this extra mode called the Fourth Survivor, and oh my god.
This is Nighthawk. Come in, Alpha. Alpha, do you read?
Nighthawk, this is Hunk from Alpha Team.
Oh, fuck!
Oh, shit!
I will murder.
Murder! Murder!
You get the shotgun, you fucking bitch! Fuck you! What?! Fuck! Fuck! Shit! Fuck you, you stupid asshole! Oh! Fuck you! Oh shit! Fuck! What the fuck? Alpha Team, you suck ass!
What the fuck?
Oh my god! Oh!
This mode was hard on my first 5 tries, or was it 15? I don't know, wasn't really keeping track. In the fourth Survivor, I got to play this guy named Hunk from Alpha Team, and all I had to do is survive all the way from the sewers up to the surface with only the supplies it provided for me. It is very obvious that I didn't read the description below the fourth Survivor, because I had no idea that this was going to be a quick time event. I tried so hard to not do the one thing that would cheat my way into beating this fucking level. I did the one thing that put shame to my conscience. I did one thing that made me sick to my stomach. The one thing that kept me from sleeping at night. The one thing that I promised myself that I will never ever do. And I mean, I will never, maybe never, ever do it again. Do you want to know what I did? I ask you again, do you want to know my sin? I'll tell you what I did! I looked it up on YouTube.
Okay. I'm going to look it up on YouTube to see if anyone was able to beat this. This entire time I've been playing this game, I was dumb enough to not check whether shooting him in the leg would be a solution. I didn't watch the whole thing, but just watching that, but in like a minute, I'm fucking pissed right now.
All I had to do was shoot the zombies in the legs, and that would solve all my problems. And that's the one thing I'm such an idiot for not thinking that in my first story mode playthrough. God damn it! On the other hand, the fourth Survivor actually did help me use a few particles in my brain cells to get through the hardcore mode of Leon and Claire. I would consider this as, shooting practice. After beating the fourth Survivor, I got to play as Tofu. Listen, I don't care what anybody says about Tofu, in the end, he's still a badass. Later, after Resident Evil 2 was released, it got free DLC called The Ghost Survivors. It's very similar to the fourth Survivor, only difference is I got to play 3 characters who never made out of Raccoon City. This shows what happens if they did survive the outbreak. In my opinion, The Ghost Survivor is a lot harder than the fourth Survivor, considering the fact that each character has their own difficulty, and I never got to master any of them. I hope there's more DLCs coming to Resident Evil 2, because I really did find a lot of fun in the QuickTime mode.
What the fuck? You stupid bitch! You are a stupid bitch! Stupid bitch! Oh my god! Push me? Ambush me? Bitch, I quit.
It is so generous for Capcom to give us free DLC, gave me another reason to play the game over and over. Not only are these addicting, but there's so much to achieve. I know that unlocking character models is nothing new. They've been around the gaming industry for a very long time, but I just love the character models in Resident Evil 2. Please, for the love of God, If anyone has a talent for it, or if anyone has a passion for it, please build these models and sell it on Etsy. I will definitely buy it from you, just as long as it's under $200. Please, please sell Etsy. I love Etsy. Please, Etsy! And one of the best things to unlock is the original costume designs in Resident Evil 1998. It is so cool to see Leon and Claire in their original outfit from 1998. Yes, I know it's already been done to death in previous games. You can unlock it in, you can mod it in, but just looking at the textures in this modern engine, it looks so good! I'm surprised they didn't do the Leon Resident Evil 4 costume yet, huh? I was able to unlock landscape art, and for someone who likes to actually do art for a hobby, this is just really fucking cool to look at. There is a lot of phenomenal artwork to look at. If only they utilized some of this concept and actually put it in the game, then that would be awesome! There's one more thing I'd like to talk about before ending this review, and that's the soundtrack. Of all Resident Evil soundtracks that I've listened to, including the movies, Resident Evil 2 Remake soundtrack disappointed me quite a bit. There is not one track that I can remember from the Resident Evil 2 score. There's not even a main theme. There is one really cool soundtrack that played in the opening credits of Resident Evil 2. It was only played once. And the composer didn't even try to mix it up a bit. In games, films, and shows, there's most likely a theme. There's a dramatic theme, the expedition theme, and of course the epic version of the same fucking theme. The least the composer could have done is modernize the 1998 soundtrack, but there is a solution to that. If you don't like the soundtrack, or if you just want to listen to the original soundtrack from 1998, you can go into the store, purchase it, and listen to it in the background as you're playing the modern version of Resident Evil 2. You gotta be fucking kidding me! I really don't know what to say about this. This is amazing! Capcom, thank you! Those are my fair shares of most of the goods and some of the bads in these games. In the end, the story did not turn out as well as I was hoping it was gonna be, but gameplay and content is where they did justice! With free DLC, with mostly free content, and the fact that this is not an online service, Capcom has done a lot of good for this game. It's not their best, but it's a project that they didn't even have to give us a remake, and I'm so glad that they did. I had such a fun time with this game. It is an excellent single-player experience. It's one of the best Resident Evil games that I've ever played, and it's one of the best horror games that I've ever played. My final score for Resident Evil 2 Remake is an 8 out of 10. Resident Evil 2 is a fantastic game. I still find it one of the best of 2019, and I myself still feel like celebrating. In fact, Champ Looty, hit that shit. It's been a very long time since Capcom has released a Resident Evil title that I'm truly invested in. The fact that this game managed to bring in old school fans and first timers into this masterclass experience is awesome! If you have a little bit of faith in Capcom, then help us support them by buying it or at least renting it. Show Capcom that we give a damn! If the word out is true that Resident Evil 3 is in the works right now, then I have full faith in Capcom. I'm excited for it and I'm looking forward to it. Until then, I'll be playing more Resident Evil 2. Well, thank you so much for watching. I hope you liked this review. If you do, go and click the like button, click the bell, subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you every time I see you. Oh, yeah. You took all the shit I had, not to fall apart, and try hard to live the peace.